But another goal for the young Whelan. With homegrown talent finding a place in the league top scorers chart, and Whelan just one of more than half a dozen players from the FA Youth Cup winning team to have found a place in the professional squad, the future for United could be very bright indeed. To find out how bright, we've been talking to Paul Hart, Director of Youth Development at Elland Road.
We've got 18 on the YTS scheme, ranging from 16 to 18. And we hope that within that period of 2 years, they sign professional terms. They have to reach a certain standard, obviously, and we are very selective. We're selective from 9 years of age, and we're aiming for the best. It's a tough world, and so we have to be extremely selective. We've got boys from the North East and from all over Yorkshire, Manchester and Scotland. So they come from wherever we can find them.
I stay in Peebles up in Scotland and played football all my life really. And my first professional club was St Johnstone, and I signed for them when I was 16 on apprentice forms. But then about Christmas time, I left them and I came down here for a trial for a couple of weeks, and I was signed on. It just really happened from there. I think the standard of football's a lot better down here than up in Scotland.
We have our own hostel which accommodates 10 boys and two other digs that accommodate 3 and 4. So we provide that. That it's paid for, the accommodation's paid for. And beyond that, we care for their well-being. We're the extra parental arm. When parents have to feel that when they release them into our care that they're going to be well looked after. And so far, we feel we're doing a good job.
Yeah, it gets hard sometimes when you're away for a few weeks. But, you cope, you get used to it after a while. But yeah, it does get hard sometimes when you're maybe on a downer, you're not playing so well, you miss your family, your friends, whatever. It is very tough, to be honest. Training's quite hard. I mean, you only train for maybe a couple of hours, 3 hours a day, but these like 3 hours are very, very hard. If you do running or a lot of work with the ball, it is very hard, and it is like physically taxing over the season. And of course, you've got the jobs then after that, and if you're really tired after training, it's, you know, you can't be bothered doing the job, but you just got to get on with it and do the best you can, because, I mean, it's not only like the football side that you can get into trouble for if you're not playing well, but if the jobs aren't done right, things like that, it's all taken into account. So we live about sort of half an hour away from the ground, so we're up normally about 7 o'clock in the morning. We get the bus about 20 to 8, and we change in town, and we're here at Elland Road at about 8:30. And we have to be in here, have to sign our name in the office and be changed by 9 o'clock. And then we come into the boot room here and clean our players' boots, whatever, get the kit ready for the pros. And we start training about 10 o'clock, 10:30 normally. Train till about 12. And we come in for lunch in the canteen. And maybe go out for a wee while in the afternoon. Maybe an hour and a half, sometimes. I think we probably do a bit more than the professionals, really. Obviously, because they play more games than us, so, and it's of a higher scale, you've got to be fitter and everything. So like they need more rest. I think we play less games, so we do a lot more training. We're like learning our trade, so we've got to do a lot more with the ball, practice our skills, things like that.
We aim to give them the best training and coaching available in the hope that they learn the good habits so that even if they don't benefit us, they will benefit another club, perhaps lower down.
So just how important is youth development to the future of Leeds? We asked Paul how the boss himself sees it.
5 years ago when he came to the club, he laid the basis of this present youth policy. It was a new one, new attitudes towards it. He's very keen that it works. He's put a lot of time into it. he feels he's got the right people to run it, and equally we hope we don't disappoint him.